Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna take you on a little, I don't know what the word is, adventure, journey, following me around in the morning, what my morning routine is. I basically just show you guys how to do this makeup look. My like go-to, what I stick to when I'm in a rush, and then besides that, what I make for my breakfast today. It's not always the same, but sometimes it is. Let's get started, you guys. To prime my face, I'm using this Beauty Counter Adaptive Moisture Lotion, and it's the best thing ever, whether you have dry or oily skin. It is just the best kind of moisturizer. And then I'm using this Naked palette, like the third kind of middle shade color. You can kind of do this with any palette that's just a middle color. And then I'm using this lighter color as a base, and just using my finger to apply it. And it doesn't matter if it's messy right now, guys. And then I'm just blending it out again with either that same color or just your brush. Got to take a tea break, obviously. And then I'm just using that color, except this one is a little bit darker. I'm using a darker color for this, just to put in my crease as well. And this is kind of like defining it more. So, and then I'm using my same eye blending brush to blend it out.
Now I'm just using a brow
brush to like brush out my brows, obviously. And then I'm using Anastasia the Dip Brow Pomade, and I believe it's in the color
Auburn.
And I normally don't like to go this dark, but lately I've just been doing it on the ends because my brows are like too bare.
Next trick
is something that people normally leave out, but I really like to do it because it just helps add some definition, and I don't know, it just makes your makeup look all flow together. But basically I'm just outlining my brows, and I'm using the Urban Decay concealer, and it is good for this case. You don't always have to have a lighter concealer under your eyes necessarily, but I like to use a lighter concealer, especially for underneath my brows or about or like around my brows, just because it adds a cooler effect and just makes them look more clean. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm just kind of outlining them, and then obviously the foundation will go all around it after. Now take your beauty blenders, and I get mine from Sephora. Those are the only ones that have worked for me so far. And then I'm using this Makeup Forever foundation, which I love. I just don't love this color, so I'm still trying to get another color. But I love the consistency of this foundation. If you have more dry skin like I do, then this is something that is really nice if you like that glowy look. I've been lately doing like a less foundation look, so I just dabbed it a little bit in the main areas that are red on my face, and then I'm just blending it out with the beauty blender. If there's anything I recommend after watching this video, like to actually buy, it would be this product, the Milk Blush in the color Perk, or whatever color suits you. But I'm just putting it in the blush areas, basically when you smile, and my nose, and then my chin. But yeah, this product is everything. I just love the way that it makes you look so glowy and peachy and just cute. And I also like to add like a cream contour if I have one. I don't actually know the brand of this, but just to add some definition basically before I do like my main powder bronzer. Next is powder bronzer, speaking of. Basically, I learned this from Bella Thorne on her Snapchat stories or something. She put it in her eyes and like on her nose, and as well as obviously like the indents of your cheek and whatever they're called. But I thought it was a really interesting look, and it actually adds a lot, and I've been sticking to it ever since. And now I'm adding just some powder blush on top of the Milk makeup blush. This is just for extra blush if you want to look extra, extra blushy. I forgot where I learned this, but when in doubt, use baby powder. Anyways, I'm using baby powder for setting, like a setting powder, and this occasionally works. This is what I'll do if I don't have anything on hand, but it does, like I have mixed feelings about it. Sometimes I like it. It's just, it works if you have a really shiny face and you don't want it so shiny. But I think something about just the whiteness of the powder, it sometimes makes it look really weird.
highlight. So this is obviously the Becca Champagne Pop highlighter, and I use a little brush to put it on my brow bone to highlight it. And this is one of my favorite parts, you guys, because who doesn't want to look like a glowing goddess? So I also add it in my inner corners of my eyes, and then before I do like the main highlight on my cheekbones, I will brush off all of the excess baby powder, and then I take a larger brush. This one always works so well for me. And then yeah, I basically just put it on the top corners of my cheek. I try not to go too towards my face, and not too low either, because I don't want it to completely mix in with the blush, but it's just that high point. And sometimes you can tell if you like look at the light, and when you're looking in a mirror, if you like move your face around, you kind of will see a natural glow, and I try to just go off of that. And then I also just put a little bit on my forehead and my nose as well. If you want to get really technical with it, I like to use my pinky finger to do a little button dot on my top of my nose and then down the streak of my nose if you want it to be really defined. Ever since I started doing this, I just love the way my nose looks because it makes it small and it's just like shiny in all the right spots. Then I just kind of blend it all out with a bigger foundation brush or whatever brush you want to use. And then this is also a really nice product. It's the Anastasia Brow Gel, and it's clear, but I like it because you can make your eyebrows kind of any shape you want, and if you want some hairs going up, which is kind of the look I like, it just looks more natural and full. It stays all day, which is nice. And now I'm using the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. Yes, I'm a basic girl. And this is just for my lashes. But honestly, you guys, I really don't think it's so much about what kind of mascara you use. It's so much just about technique and like making sure that you kind of brush your lashes all the way out. And sometimes you make a mistake and it's okay because you can just fix it with other foundation or whatever. Yeah, so that's all I'm doing here. And because my other mascara is almost out, I just have used this other like drugstore brand, and I just really go hard on the mascara. That's why people think I have fake eyelashes, but it's really just because I do like 10 or 20 layers of mascara. So if that's what you want, that look of fake eyelashes and whatever, do a lot of mascara. So for lips, I'm using the Sonia Kashuk lip liner. I don't know what color, something natural. It's so low at this point that I don't remember. But anyways, I'm just overlining a little bit, and I am gonna place a different color on top. It's the Urban Decay Ultra Shine Lip Gloss, and I was just using a sample. This is the first time I've used this, but I normally don't like red lip glosses, but I actually ended up really liking the end result of this look because it brought out like the peachiness in my cheeks, and I don't know, sometimes it's just a red lip, and even if it's shiny, it's nice. And we are finally done with this makeup tutorial. Yay!
I've done my makeup and picked out an outfit. We'll go to the kitchen to make breakfast. I also definitely make note of saying all my affirmations in the morning because this is a hard world, so it's good to remind yourself who you are and who you want to be during and throughout the day. So I will say things like, you are powerful, you are strong, you are beautiful, you are smart, you are wise, you are friendly, you are kind, you are loving, you are yourself, and that's okay. So that's enough of that. Let's go get breakfast. So lately I've just been having yogurt. I'm using today are Greek yogurt, cranberries for some flavor, walnuts or any kind of nuts, I guess, and then chia seeds and coconut shreds. Sometimes I will add honey, but I'm trying to stay off the sugar for a little bit. So this is what I'm gonna make this morning. And I just mix it together and it makes a great parfait. Oh, blueberries, I forgot blueberries. I don't have that many left, but you can use this or like frozen fruit or something. Done with the finished touch. It looks kind of gross, but you guys, I swear it is the best thing.
So now I'm just gonna eat and then head to work and then edit this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, share. Yeah, and there'll be more of them coming soon. All right, bye.